like a shark in a shrimp tank. Big fish, small pond in the shrimp tank. When it's
a... Welcome to the post-show wrap-up of the Shrimp Tank. I'm Brad Berger, along with my co-host Dan Whedon. And our guest today is Dr. Peter Lehmann with Vintage Direct Primary Care. We just had an intriguing and fun conversation with Dr. Lehmann, and to listen to the entire podcast, visit seattle.shrimptankpodcast.com or subscribe to our podcast on iTunes. We're always interested in your feedback, so please do not forget to rate us. So, Dr. Lehmann, you've had quite a journey from what I'll call the old world of medicine to the new world of medicine. Can you talk a little bit about that journey and what brought you to where you are today?
Sure. Thanks for having me on. So I was a family physician for about two decades practicing in Kitsap County as part of a large multi-specialty group. And boy, towards the end of that last 20 years, I found myself getting pretty close to being burned out. Just the practice of medicine had become so busy with paperwork and satisfying regulations and spending less and less time with patients. And I really was finding myself truly burned out. I mean, I love being a doctor, but the day-to-day job was really unpleasant. So probably two or three years ago, I decided I needed to do something different. I needed to find a new sort of practice. And so I moved into solo practice January of 2016.
I want to talk a little bit about the concept of membership-based medicine. That's a foreign concept, I think, to most people out there. It was to me until I became a patient. Talk a little bit about if somebody were to want to join your clinic, how does that look for them?
Sure. So traditional medical practice, you buy insurance and you use your insurance to go see your physician in the office. And if you don't see your physician in the office, the physician doesn't get paid. It's a system based upon having a certain volume of patients coming through the office and being seen for person-to-person visits. Well, I looked at other memberships that are successful, Amazon, Netflix, gym memberships, and said, what do they have in common? Well, they all offer a lot of value, and they offer it with a service perspective geared towards their clients. And I said, well, why can't that be done with medical care? So my patients pay a fixed monthly fee. It's an average $50 to $60 a month. And I provide all the care that I am trained to do as a family physician. That's procedures, that's office visits for chronic care, that's house calls if needed, that's sewing up lacerations. I mean, you name it. What I can do, I do. Visits with no co-payments, texting, email, taking advantage of any sort of technology to provide a huge amount of value for what I consider to be a reasonable cost. So it's quite a bit like if you'd imagine the way you live your life with other insurance plans. Auto insurance you use for serious catastrophes. You don't go down to Shuck's Auto Store and say, well, what wiper blades are on my plan for the month? If you want the Bosch wiper blades, you buy the Bosch wiper blades. So it's really an attempt to put control back into the patient's hands. What it does for me is I don't have to deal with the insurance hassles, quite honestly, that's what they are. And so I can work directly for the patient. I can spend the time that I would have been involved with insurance, spending it with patients. And it's allowed me to drop down the number of patients I needed to see by day or to be responsible for. So now I've got probably 500 to 600 patients who I really know quite intimately and really are sort of an extension of the family.
And I'll add on to this before Brad asks this final question. And your patients don't wait in waiting rooms for hours. They walk straight in, right?
Correct. I think the longest a patient has waited for me is about 10 minutes. And that was because I wasn't paying close enough attention and the patient before and I were having such a good time. But we literally debated not having a waiting room. You have a 3 o'clock appointment. You have a 3 o'clock appointment.
So many of our listeners may be kind of scratching their head, I think, like many of us are, which is, you know, entrepreneurship and medicine. I mean, those seem like the two furthest things from each other of things that you could pair up. But you really are an entrepreneur. So could you talk to our audience, since many of them listen about entrepreneurship and owning a business and running a business or starting a business, just a little bit about your entrepreneur's journey?
Sure. So most people wouldn't know this, but when you go to medical school, you don't learn a thing about running a business. And although I was an owner in a, you know, a very large medical clinic, we had a CEO and a CFO. I basically saw patients. When I got to this point where I felt like I needed to do something different, I just happened to come across a 5-minute podcast from an entrepreneurial physician in Wichita, Kansas, who brought up this idea of direct primary care, a membership-based medical practice. I called him on the phone a few minutes later, spent 15 or 20 minutes, and I was convinced this was what I was going to do. Once I had the idea, I basically learned on the job everything I needed to know about running a business. And it's been a crazy ride, but absolutely 100% worth it. Would never go back to the old ways. If there are physicians listening to this, I would absolutely say, you know, if you need to change your life, you can. And physicians are smart enough to be entrepreneurs.
The power of podcasts, right?
Absolutely. I was just thinking of that.
Absolutely.
How many lives are we touching with the shrimp tank?
Yeah, the power of podcasts. Well, we want to thank Dr. Peter Lehmann for joining us. Dr. Lehmann, how can our listeners get in touch with you if they want to learn more?
Sure. You can reach me by email. It's drpeter, that's like Dr. Peter, at vintagedpc.com. So vintage is like the old word vintage, like our medical care, V-I-N-T-A-G-E. DPC is direct primary care. So drpeter at vintagedpc.com. Our website is www.vintagedpc.com.
Well, once again, this is just a taste of what you can expect by listening to the entire podcast. Visit seattle.shrimptankpodcast.com or subscribe to our podcast on iTunes. We'd love to hear from you, so please do not forget to rate us.
Well, our next guest is Pat Larson, CEO of Zen Ledger. If he's going to come in a motorcycle?
I'm not sure.
So Pat Larson, CEO of Zen Ledger. It's a brand new startup that seeks to simplify tax calculations for cryptocurrencies. You won't want to miss this. So join us back in the tank for our next show on March 21st. For right now, the hay is in the barn.